Go for it.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Joe Code. I am the host of this podcast. My name is Joe Marrese. This is the podcast of food, beer, and men. And all things having to do with that, really. And then having to do with a lot of other things also. And if you've been following closely, I do now have healthy eyes. I've got contacts again. I've got better contacts. I can even see clear. This is the first eye doctor that told me I have astigmatism in my left eye and gave me a different contact than I had, and now I see sharpness everywhere. I can see everything, and it feels good. Sorry to those that are like, hey, I loved you in the glasses. You looked really good. I really liked them. Where are the glasses? They're in the medicine cabinet where they belong.
Yeah.
Top right in the cabinet. They'll be staying in there. They will not be returning unless you are with me late at night. And I take my contacts out and I brush my teeth. That's when you can see the glasses. Otherwise, you won't see them.
Do you put them on first thing in the morning, too?
No. I put them... Usually, I don't put them on until early afternoon, like when I first head out. Because I think wearing them like 12 hours a day is probably good.
Yeah.
Don't want to wear them too much more than that. But today, I had to get up at the crack of 9:30 a.m. We're doing this early podcast today. So they're in now. And I typically would get redness in the eye in the morning, but yeah, feeling good. Yeah. Don't have any pain and like, yeah, but my eyes needed the contact lens break and I have a different brand now and, things are looking good. One thing I will say, well, you couldn't even really see it, but I am wearing shorts today. I realized I didn't have any clean pants. I thought I did have my one pair of jeans. I know we usually don't wear shorts here. This is a professional podcast. One of the most professional out there, some would say.
I mean, speak for yourself. I'm almost always in shorts here.
Yeah, you're always in shorts. Yeah, I mean, it's not a big deal. I mean, you know, whatever. Looks good. It's not like people aren't watching it. They're not going to be distracted by my legs. You know, they're not going to miss out on who wins the cheese championship because they were staring at my legs. They're still going to be honed in on that. Which we do have a big championship match coming up between mozzarella and cheddar. That's a big one. We've got that. We got that coming up, and we also have we were talking about a lot of foods. We had the world cuisines. I've been trying to expound on being more cultured. I just went to a Vietnamese restaurant, mm-hmm. and... apparently, I told my friend Alex Young, who's a comedian who works with me at the Comedy Store. He's Vietnamese. And I showed him the place, and he immediately said, it's not legit. It isn't legit. He goes, you won't see me going there. Because they do like a fusion thing, and he's like, no, that's not it. I'm like, okay, whatever. I don't know.
That's a start.
I mean, should I go in there like Jerry Seinfeld, like Babu Bhatt, like convince him to go all, go all Pakistani? Not, don't hold back, go full Vietnamese. But it's interesting, it's like one of those build your own bowl kind of situations. I mean, it's just like you could put rice, noodles, then you add the meat, then you could add some veggies, then you could add like crunchy or crispy onions or peanuts on top, and then some sauce. Thought it was fine.
Sure.
But Alex wasn't into it. You know, he's like, you got to go to Alhambra or whatever.
Yeah.
We're one of those heavy Asian communities. And I, okay, fine. Well, this place is right down the street from yeah. me. So, whatever, man.
You could head to Irvine. There's a heavy Asian population there.
Yeah, also there.
And then on your way back, hit Portillo's.
Oh, yeah, you know that. Right there in Buena Park. My neighborhood is being taken over by the robots now. I've seen so many more. I was talking with my Uber driver. He's like, the guy that gave me a ride, he's like in tech, and he was talking about them too. And it's like how people are like vandalizing the robots. These delivery robots. It's like, I guess there's like a lot of videos on YouTube of people like messing with them and like breaking them. And like, I joke around about, you know, it's funny, like, these robots are like stalking me. But yeah, I mean, you got to be some kind of psycho to like beat up a robot.
Yeah.
It's like, come on. You know, people are delivering those things are trying to deliver the food. I mean, I'm not going to actually mess with them. I'm not some psycho. You know.
I mean, we don't have them at all this side of the mountains, so.
They're right on, I mean, they're all over Sunset.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Like, right by, like, the Laugh Factory. You know, I'm running into Juliet a lot, Otto, Behar.
So what I'm hearing is, if they're by the Laugh Factory, they're huge Dane Cook fans.
Yeah, they're lining up for Dane, trying to get a glimpse of him getting out of his car. That's funny. Yeah, they kind of are like camped out over there, it seems like, and then they'll get pinged for their deliveries, and hopefully the people will get their food and some lunatic won't beat them up. But you can get, like, because those things have cameras. So yeah. If they catch you, you'll get in trouble.
So does the robot pick up the food and then take it? Or does the robot come from a place that makes the food?
Yeah, I don't know how the food gets in the robot.
Right?
It must pull up on the sidewalk outside of the restaurant. And then I'm guessing one of the restaurant workers brings it outside, puts it inside the robot, which basically looks like a cooler.
Yeah, a cooler on wheels.
If you were to go, if you were to go to the beach or something, it just looks like one of your big coolers that you would put beer or pop in, or, you know, or soda, if you will. But yeah, those things. Yeah, lay off the robots, okay? They're delivering food. They're nice. They come in peace. Don't be a lunatic and beat up a robot. Unless it's threatening you.
Exactly.
Jeez. It's nuts. All right, let's do a This Is Sucks, and then we'll get into some brackets here. So I got a This Is Sucks coming up. And This Sucks right now is I've got severe holes in my socks and underwear. The essentials are just crumbling at the seams. Literally, I've had to just toss so many socks and underwear, putting on a pair of socks, big toe going right through, just no chance to, the toes don't have a chance in that, just the big toe poking out, can't do it, underwear, holes left and right, and that you got to toss them. Man, I really could use, wish it was Christmas time and, you know, you'd be a kid when you'd get a gift of clothes, you'd be like, oh, man. You get a box, you shake it, and you hear the swishing of the... You're like, oh, this is going to be some clothes. And it would just be a big thing of socks. I could go for that right now. Yeah. Big thing of socks wrapped up. Some nice boxer briefs. But as an adult, you can just go shopping, which is what I'll do. But I just find it interesting that they basically... all my socks and underwear decide to expire all at once. I mean, it's been a gradual, like, there's been a few over the last couple months, but now it's just like, they're all ready to hang it up. They're retiring.
You can get all that stuff on Amazon if you want a robot to deliver it.
Yeah, we can have the robots bring it too. I mean, yeah, just as long as it's not Mina. See, Mina, she backed into me, but I didn't.
You didn't destroy
I didn't
her.
Retaliate.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, I held back from the robot, you know. I'm not going to lash out at the robot. Yeah. My plan was to do actually the Vietnamese food thing because I did like it. That was going to be a this is great, but Alex turned me off to it. By saying it wasn't legit, so I didn't want to shout it out then. All right, let's do here. I want to do a couple emails because I have a couple of those, and then I want to start getting into Adam's sauce bracket that he gave us the last couple weeks, which he has now finalized and. You know, we're ready to get into that. But let's do this. We just got a few emails. Folks, remember, you could email me here, joecodepodcast@gmail.com. We talk all things food, beer, and men. It's a great time. We love your emails. We'll read them all. And I got just three here this week. We've got one coming in right now from Greg. Greg from Minnesota. In regards to grilling, we were talking grilling a lot. And Greg says, in response to last week's email on what to grill next, I would suggest a frozen Jack's pizza. Ooh.
Huh.
Adds a good crisp and comes out much better than in the oven. Wow. Thanks, Greg from Minnesota. Yeah, I've heard about pizza on the grill, and I would imagine it's a lot just like one of those, like, the wood-burning oven kind of things. I would imagine it comes out in a similar way with, like, a crispy crust. But, yeah, I do remember Jack's Pizza. That's a good frozen pizza. Grilling pizza, I want to be a part of that.
It seems like that wouldn't get that nice crispy top layer. You know.
You don't think the bottom will get it?
The bottom will get it, but it won't brown the cheese or anything, or it'll take forever to do that. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. That's, yeah, maybe.
I'm into the pizza oven idea. I kind of want one of those, but.
Yeah, that's like what we got at the Comedy Store with the pizzas we have now. Those pizza ovens are great. I mean, it cooks these, like, frozen, these pizzas that we get, these handmade, super thin, like, cooks them in, like, 3 minutes.
Yeah.
It's amazing. All right, here is one from Tyler. Subject is Burger King. All right, let's get into it. Hey, dudes, I feel as though BK gets totally disrespected in the fast food game. The charbroiled burgers, the fries, the lettuce, tomato, onion, and mayo as the norm for the Whopper is elite. They made a damn good fried chicken sandwich during the whole chicken sandwich craze of a couple years ago, not to mention their elite marketing game. I don't know. I just feel like they're slept on. It's kind of like how everyone just agreed to hate on Nickelback. Everyone just suddenly started hating on BK. I don't know. Maybe I'm the weird one. All the love, Tyler. Yeah, I agree, Ty. I was on that bandwagon of trashing BK. I got on board with that. I was one of those. I don't know. Burger King just kind of didn't make its way into my adult life. I mean, I grew up with a fantastic Burger King really close to my house. If my Park Ridge natives and friends that listen to this, you remember that Burger King on Bussey Highway. It was a great Burger King. You know, you could dine in there. Drive-through was never too crazy. I mean, I remember not really having problems with it, and it was close to the baseball field, Hinkley Park, where we would play a lot of baseball games. So a lot of good memories of that Burger King and Whoppers. And as a kid, I was a big Whopper Jr. guy. That Whopper Jr., that was for me. You know, as a little kid, you're like, the Whopper, that's a little scary. That's a big sandwich. You're like, I don't know. It's a little too much. And then once the Whopper Jr. came around, I'm like, ooh, man, you got me, Burger King. You know how to get the kids into the Whopper. Just make it smaller. And they did, and it was great. I mean, I remember their chicken, I believe they called theirs chicken tenders. But then their original chicken sandwich, I remember the long, thin one. Not long and thin, but, you know, it just was a long rectangle. That was great.
Yep.
And, yeah, the mayo, the lettuce, the onions were always solid. I don't know. Yeah, maybe it's time to get back to BK. Maybe we gotta, you know, maybe BK's like one of those players that never made it into the Hall of Fame, that it's like, hey, we overlooked their stats. Maybe we need to get them in, you know? Yeah, I think we are sleeping on BK, and but I don't know. And where we live now, I mean, Aaron, how many? I'm trying to think. Okay, yeah, there is the one Burger King in Hollywood.
Yeah,
there's one there at La Brea and Sunset.
Yeah.
So there's that one, but other than that, that's the only one I could think of in this region.
Well, there's one right around the corner.
Oh, there is?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's the Burger King from the beginning of Back to the Future.
Oh, it is.
It's a huge plus for me.
Okay, that's fun.
Yeah, I'm there a lot, and I do think they're being slept on. I think in terms of the size of a burger you get there dwarfs what you're going to get at McDonald's. So if that's what you're into, for the same price you're getting, if you're paying for a Big Mac that's like squished,
yeah,
you're going to get a much bigger, you know, double, you know, like a Bacon King or a Stacker King. Those are really good. I don't love the Whopper that much, but I explore the rest of the menu.
Yeah, I mean, the Whopper, I mean, I would do a Whopper with cheese. They used to do the Western Whopper.
Mm-hmm.
Which is kind of whatever, like barbecue sauce and shit. Okay, yeah. Next time I'm not gonna do Wendy's late night. Next time I want a late night drive through, I'm gonna pass on Wendy's and I'm gonna opt for Burger King next time. Burger King, they deserve another chance.
They're right across the street from each other on Sunset and La Brea, aren't they?
Yeah, it's right close by. And that Wendy's drive-thru late at night is a bit of a nightmare.
Yeah.
I don't know what they're doing in there.
Yeah, the BK fries are good. The chicken fries are good. The nuggets are good.
Yeah, I remember that.
They have a... I don't know what's on the value menu.
They had a good crispy crispy chicken sandwich, I remember. Like you can get it regular, spicy.
Yeah, they're working on all that.
Value menu.
They have like a chicken parm in the long chicken.
Oh, right. They do that.
You know, and you drive up there, you say, you know, they say, hey, welcome to Burger King. You rule. I just need that affirmation.
They say that?
Yep. That's a new thing.
The person says it or it's on a recording? The
person says it.
Would they say, welcome to Burger King, you rule?
Yep. Yeah.
Wow, because it's like Burger King, so like you rule, like ruler of the kingdom, you think?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And we got to remember, they would give out the crown to kids.
They still do. Yeah, still do.
That's probably the most fun fast food. You know, you'd get little toys in the Happy Meal, but wearing that little golden crown.
Yeah.
That's pretty fun.
Yeah. Because you go to the only other place that does something like that is In-N-Out. They'll give you a little hat.
Yeah, the little hat. But
it's like, I don't want to look like I work here.
Yeah.
I want to look like I rule.
Yeah, the crown is royalty.
Yeah.
So if I'm wearing the crown. All right. Yeah. Burger King. And you know what? The breakfast I remember too now. I mean, now it's all just hitting me.
Yeah, breakfast is good.
The French toast sticks?
Yeah, the croissants.
The croissant witches are great.
Uh-huh. They have a breakfast burrito that's pretty good.
All right, yeah, I mean, we're just... now that I'm like... I'm just getting hit with stats now. You know, I gotta... Gotta talk to the committee here and get these guys in the hall.
Yeah.
All right, Burger King, I'll be back. I'll be back. Thanks, everybody, for supporting Burger King and getting them getting their name back out there. All right, here's one from Trevor. He's got it says men question. Hey, Joe, I got a question about men, specifically names of men. My father, grandfather, and myself all have the initials TLN. To keep the tradition alive, I have to name my firstborn son a T name. For years, I have been decided that it will be Travis. I am from the East Coast, so I don't know any Travises, but I imagine them to be cool. Any suggestions, or am I on the right track? Thanks, Trevor. Yeah, your name's Trevor, your son Travis. Yeah, I mean, I think that's fun. Both start with TR. That's a good name.
Trevor is cooler than Travis.
Trevor, yeah. Yeah, Travis.
The one Travis I grew up with was kind of a schmoll. But don't let that stop you.
Travis can be a schmoll name, I feel like. I mean, with T, of course, you got Thomas.
My middle name, yeah.
You could go with Tank.
Ooh.
yeah. No, that's typically a nickname. I don't know why that popped in my head, but that could be funny. Hopefully your son will grow up to be an offensive lineman. Thomas, what do you got? Pretty much it.
Tim.
Terry.
Yep.
Todd's not bad. Todd's kind of strong and
you got Taylor.
Those are in the same family of Travis. Mm-hmm. Trent.
Ooh.
Trent's kind of cool.
It's kind of strong. It's abrupt.
Yeah. But yeah, Trevor, you're on the right track. I mean, I certainly don't want to name your son. I mean, unless you want to give me that honor. But I think you're on the right track with Travis. I think that's fine. If that's what your gut is telling you, because he says for years you've been decided that it's Travis. So I don't want to sway you if that's what you're feeling. But these are the other T option names. And some are stronger than others. I mean, Travis is fine. Trent. Yeah, I mean, the TR, because your name's Trevor, I like that you would have the same first two initials. But, thanks for asking about men, Trevor. I appreciate the man question. That's the end of the emails there. I just wanted to mention one other thing about my... So with my eye, with the bacteria infection, it did leave a scar in my eye, which you think, what? A scar in your eye? Yeah, on my eyeball, there is a little like white speck, like a little dot that apparently will be there forever, which is cool. It was white. Now it's like clear. Like you really can't see it. I see it. It could fade. It might not. And I like how now that I'm talking about the eye, it's like itching now. What are you hearing me? Get out of here. Don't want to rub my eyes. But so there's that. I'm used to having scars though. I got scars everywhere. I mean, I got scars, all over my face, really. I have the one up here. I've got the one here. Now I've got one in the eye. Got the scar on the arm. Scar me up. It's not going to stop me. But, I'm lucky. Because if the infection was in my sight line, I could have, like, blurred vision. Yeah. That would have been fucking sucked ass. But we're in the clear, we're safe. And
I have a scar between my eye and my eyebrow from when I was a kid, and it was a boat oar hit me.
So now your eyelid, like this part?
Yeah, over to the side, yeah.
Damn.
Got my first concussion.
A boat oar? What?
And we were playing in the pool in the backyard, and I was trying to tip my sister over. She was in a little inflatable raft with oars.
Yeah.
And I just caught one in the eye.
Whew. Yeah, that's a mean one.
Yeah. I don't think she meant it. I was fucking around.
Oh, yeah, I have one up here, too. Hockey stick, golf club. Man. Both done by my brother, by the way.
I was going to say, Marty McSorley?
Jeez. One was on purpose, one was on accident.
I would hope the golf club was accident.
Yeah. Yeah, you hope, I didn't grow up with Casey Jones.
Yeah. I used to say I had the three weirdest scars, because I got one from a seagull.
What?
One was a boat oar, and then one was frisbee golf.
Yeah, I mean, frisbee golf. Come on. Would it hit you in the face?
No, I just fell down while I was frisbee golfing. And so I had a scar that I just say, I blamed it on the frisbee golf.
Nice.
But yeah, seagull at SeaWorld, we were trying to, I was feeding the dolphins, you know, little sardines or whatever. And
seagull didn't like that?
Seagulls were flying all around, and it just came in. I was a little kid. I was like 10 or 11. And it came and pecked me on the finger.
That's interesting. I mean, I didn't think they made contact with people.
Oh, if they see a little kid with fish.
Just because it was the food?
Yeah, yeah.
Taking advantage of little kids, seagulls. I don't like that.
Yeah.
Jerk.
SeaWorld, put a net over that thing.
Do what?
They need to put a net over that area.
Yeah. Well, these friggin' gulls come in.
Although they'll probably just sit on top of the net and shit on you instead.
Yeah, they will shit. Birds like to shit everywhere. I've been shit on. All right, I want to get into Adam's Steve Irwin Memorial Sauce Championship bracket.
Okay.
This is from Adam. And...
we assume he's Australian?
Yeah, he's Australian.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, because he calls us frickin' Americans.
Yeah.
Which, that's fine with me.
Yeah, that's fair.
I mean, you guys are freaking Australians, so. But yeah, Aaron, if you have it there in the email, you can read it off.
Oh, okay.
If you want to start with the Western Conference. And towards the bottom there, he listed the matchups. And now, people, there's no more discrepancies with what he picked, what he didn't pick. We're going with what's there. Okay, some teams, not everyone can make the playoffs. Okay, maybe they'll make it next season.
All right, so we got Western Conference, round one. We got the number one seed ketchup versus number eight soy sauce.
Yeah, I mean, well seeded for ketchup. I know people these days seem to be a little down on ketchup. I seem to be meeting more people that aren't quite into it. They're like eating their fries without it. I don't need this. I'm like, all right, well, because I'll put ketchup on burgers. Mm-hmm. I'll eat ketchup with fries. I'll put ketchup on my eggs. Mm-hmm. I'll dip like random. I'll dip my club sandwich in ketchup, like if I get a turkey BLT, I'll dip a lot of things in ketchup. I've dipped tuna melts in ketchup. I mean, it just, ketchup to me is, it's still great, and I'm going to use it every time it's on the table, basically. If I'm at a restaurant and I'm eating lunch, I'm going to find something to dip in that ketchup. I'm going to be tapping the 57. The Heinz bottle is going to be pouring. I'm going to be tapping the 50. I'm not going to tap it. I'm going to give it a good hit with the heel of my hand. Tap the 57? No, I pound it. I pound the 57. Soy sauce. The thing is, I mean, it's so freaking salty.
Yeah.
I mean, it's fine. But I feel like most foods that you're eating the soy sauce with doesn't really even need the soy sauce.
Yeah.
Like you're talking mostly your Asian cuisines, and a lot of places that I go to already are putting enough like brown sauce or whatever they're cooking the dish in. There's already that sauce. I don't even necessarily need soy sauce. It's soy sauce has got a... Yeah, like I said, it just kind of... Like, when my mom used to make chop suey, we would add soy sauce. It's kind of good or whatever, but... I don't know. I don't even know if soy sauce can steal a game here. It might just be an overwhelming 4-0 ketchup sweep.
I think so. I think it's just... It doesn't have the versatility.
Yeah, soy sauce just doesn't have anything going on. I mean, it's not necessarily needed.
No.
And it's just way too salty. And I know they have the low-sodium soy sauce. I mean, there was a fun brand that makes it, Kikkoman. I remember them. It's a cool name. But yeah, ketchup advancing here to the next round quite easily.
Yeah, 4-0.
Yeah.
Next, we have number two, mustard. Versus number seven, blue cheese sauce. Or I would say blue cheese dressing.
Yeah, no one's ever said blue cheese sauce.
Yeah.
Sorry, Adam, but I don't know what they're saying in Perth or wherever you're from, but we don't say it's sauce for blue cheese. But I'll go with you on that it's being a sauce. So mustard at number two, I love. I think,
yeah.
I think mustard is a bit forgotten about.
Yeah.
The thing with mustard too, it should be like I go to Mel's Diner a lot. Mustard's not put out there on the table. I feel like it used to be years ago, especially well in Chicago, like at like hot dog, you'd go to a hot dog place. You'd have the bottle of yellow mustard. You'd have that, you know, it'd be the plastic just yellow. It was all yellow. And then you have the ketchup just that plastic all red thing. You know, they almost looked like crayons.
Yeah.
And, but now, nowadays, you got to ask for mustard. Mustard's in the back. It's not put out there. But you get a burger at a diner, you add mustard, because they're not putting it on anymore. Unless you go to, that's the thing with fast food places, they're still putting mustard on the burgers.
Yeah.
But you go to like a diner or one of these, you know, any kind of bar or pub, everyone's getting all fancy now with the burgers. They're not, they're going with these aiolis. Mm-hmm. But they forgot what got them there to where they are. These aiolis wouldn't be there if mustard didn't pave the way for them, okay? Mustard was first. All right. And then blue cheese. I do like blue cheese. I like blue cheese a lot with, I've said before, with barbecue wings. It just matches perfectly. Blue cheese, you can dip, you know, you could do, if you have like your vegetable platter, dip some carrots, celery, some cucumber in that, it's good. But mustard, I'm putting on my sandwiches, I'm putting on my burgers, I'm putting on my hot dogs. And, you know, there's other mustards as well. But I'm just thinking yellow mustard, and I think... Yeah. Yellow mustard itself is enough to take down blue cheese.
Yeah.
And blue cheese is strong. I mean, the number seven, but blue cheese has got fight in them. They do. You know. But I'll say mustard wins 4-2 over blue cheese.
I go with that. I'm not much of a blue cheese guy, but I'd give him 2 games. This next matchup, I think, is going to be close. Let's see. 3, hot sauce, parentheses, Tabasco, Frank's, or habanero, versus number 6, Big Mac / burger sauce. I assume it means the secret sauce.
Yeah. Yeah, this is good. Okay, so.
Which in most cases is Thousand Island dressing.
Right. And which I love and I think is really coming on strong these days. You know, I feel like this is their time. The burger sauce, the Big Mac sauce, because you'll get that like on smash burgers.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's great.
They're starting to sell it in stores.
Yeah. And then it's just on a classic Big Mac. Yeah. What's that?
I said the restaurant unique sauces are now being sold at stores.
Yeah, I think hot sauce is, I think they're finished. I think they've come to the end of the line here.
Yeah, I have no need for them.
I don't need it anymore. My spice, my need for the spice is gone. Tabasco, I mean, what is this, 2002, you know? Yeah, I don't need it. Frank's. Okay. Habanero, no. Get out of my face. It's too hot. Big Mac sauce, burger/burger sauce. You can dip your fries in there.
Yep.
It's delicious. Complements the burgers well. I mean, you could probably dip your chicken tenders in there.
Yeah.
I mean, 6 Seed. Yeah, they grew as a team throughout the year. They made it in these playoffs. And they're ready to topple hot sauce. Hot sauce, they are done. Okay, you're done, hot sauce. Big Mac / burger sauce wins it. All right, 4-1. I'm saying it's pretty dominating here.
Sure.
What do you think?
I'll go 4-1. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, they're taking over. Watch out for burger sauce / Big Mac sauce.
So that's an upset.
They got a two-name thing. Yeah, first upset here.
Our first upset. This next one could be close, too. Number four, aioli. Kind of general, but still.
Yeah.
Versus number five, sweet chili sauce.
I do like a sweet chili sauce.
Yeah.
There's something special about it. Because I feel like it has just the perfect amount of spice to it. I get that. I get it sometimes with my chicken wrap that I get from California Chicken Cafe, one of the world's greatest restaurants. Aioli. Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of them. Aioli's strong.
Yep. Yeah, there's a lot of good ones out there.
I mean, I can't overlook them. You could dip your fries, you put them on your burgers. You know, and these are slightly different textures. Aioli's, you know, your thicker sauce. Mm-hmm. Sweet chili sauce. I do like sweet chili. Because it's almost like, because it's like a spicy sweet and sour.
Mm-hmm.
There's something about it that's special.
Yeah. I think this is a 7-game series.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. They're slugging it out here. I mean, whew. I mean, aioli is all the craze. People like what they're doing. They've been ranked high all year. They fell a little bit. Now they're number four in this playoff matchup. I mean, does sweet chili sauce have it in them to take it over? I mean, sweet chili sauce is good with egg rolls. Can they do it? Can they take out aioli?
I think they can.
I think they can. That's what I was...
I think in an early round, yeah, I think they could.
Yeah, I mean, I know aioli, you got your different ones. Like, what are some of the main aiolis?
Garlic aioli.
Garlic.
It's really good.
That's a good one. I'm thinking of, like, a chipotle.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, it's just a little creamy.
It's a flavored mayonnaise.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, exactly. I just love the sweet chili sauce, just the taste, and then it's a little, like, not as thick.
Yeah.
I just think, sweet chili, I think, is special. And I think, they can do it. They did it in 7.
All right. They take it down 4-3.
Sweet chili sauce, yes, advancing.
Okay. Cool. So, for Eastern Conference round one, we have number one barbecue sauce versus number 8 tartar sauce.
Yeah, this is good. I do like me a tartar sauce.
I do too. But it only has so many applications. It's basically fish.
Yeah.
Nice, yeah. Fish fillet.
Yeah, on the fish fillet at McDonald's, it's delicious.
Yeah.
Fish sticks.
Mm-hmm.
I would dip fried calamari, I've dipped in tartar sauce.
Sure.
But barbecue sauce is, I mean, there's too many.
Yeah. It's dominant.
I mean, yeah. We're talking barbecue. We're talking everything barbecue. We're talking brisket. We're talking ribs. We're talking chicken.
Yeah.
And more.
In another
pork.
In a different matchup, tartar sauce could hold its own better, but this is a tough one.
I mean, barbecue sauce, I've talked about a great dipping sauce for onion rings. Just the versatility here is just, it's tough. Yeah, barbecue sauce can be tough to beat.
Yeah.
But tartar, I mean, with that soft fish fillet, I'll give tartar does make, they do get one game. They put up a strong game.
Sure.
and we'll say alone. Barbecue sauce wins in what they call a gentleman's sweep, 4-1.
Yeah, yeah. Totally fair. Yeah. Then we've got number 2, ranch, versus number 7, mayonnaise.
Yeah, so ranch to me is still one of the best there is. Mayonnaise alone, I mean, that's the thing. Here in America, we're not really dipping things in mayonnaise.
No. But it does go on a lot of stuff.
It does.
Your sub sandwiches, burger.
But ranch is just really become worldly. You could dip everything in ranch. Wings, pizza. Yeah, pretty much anything that involves chicken, you can eat with ranch. Also, bacon. I mean, you could put ranch on. That's another thing, like a sub sandwich. I've dipped ranch in. I've dipped fries in ranch, onion rings in ranch. Ranch is a classic, great flavor, and they're still riding high. They're still packing a punch, and that's why they're the number 2 seed here. And I'm gonna say ranch. I mean, mayo, all right, old timer, we'll give you a game here. I'll say another 4-1 series. Ranch wins.
Yeah. Yeah, I think so. It, you know, it could be argued still that mayo is a spread and not a sauce.
Yeah.
It is more of a, on a sandwich, it's more of a moistening agent than it is a flavor agent.
Right.
Yeah. It's made to blend.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'd go with ranch. Even though I'm not a huge ranch guy. But in this matchup, I think it makes sense.
Yeah, in this one for sure.
Okay, then we got number 3, buffalo, versus number 6, sweet and sour sauce.
Yeah, I mean, here's another one coming. Yeah, sweet and sour sauce. I love it. I really do. I like sweet and sour chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Sweet and sour, just the way the sound of that is nice. I like sweet. I like sour. It's a perfect match. I first discovered it from McDonald's. I would dip chicken nuggets in sweet and sour sauce. Buffalo, yeah, it's great on wings, but I got to be honest. A lot of times when I'm going to wing places, I'm getting the other sauces. I'm not getting buffalo that often. I'm getting garlic parmesan. I'm getting like a Asian zing, you know, I'm getting barbecue. Buffalo ain't really doing it for me.
Yeah, it's very specific.
I like sweet and sour big time in this upset here. But buffalo, there are some fantastic buffalo wings. Some sauces are really delicious, flavored well. So they'll put up a little bit of a fight, but I think sweet and sour sauce takes them out 4-2 in an upset here.
Upset, yeah, I like it.
These 6-3 matchups, you got to watch out. It's a trap game for number 3.
And then we have number 4, chipotle sauce, versus number 5, Matt Lockwood's favorite, honey mustard.
This is a tough matchup here. Now, I know I've said, I'm kind of, like I've been saying, I'm kind of over the spicy, but I'm also kind of over honey mustard.
Oh.
So these are two sauces that I'm kind of over. Kind of over, you guys. I'm over it, as they say. Yeah, these 4 or 5s are tough.
I mean, for of those two, I prefer honey mustard for sure.
Really?
Yeah, like a sweet chili's a newcomer. It's solid, but Chipotle's kind of been around and maybe lacking in hustle.
I mean,
honey mustard's like a slept-on classic.
It is. I mean, honey mustard. Well, because honey mustard, when it's a sauce and it's done right, because sometimes I've had some that are like too liquidy.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You can dip a fry in a honey mustard. It's not ideal. It's better on something. Yeah, a nugget's good for sure.
I mean, I think this is a back and forth 7-game matchup.
Sure.
I'm leaning Chipotle.
Oof. I disagree. I think Chipotle is too close to aioli in a lot of ways. Because most of them are Chipotle aiolis.
Well, yeah, because I was factoring in all the aioli. I mean, now if we're just centered on Chipotle, because, like, I'm thinking of a Chipotle sauce on, like, a nice wrap.
Yeah. Or a salad.
Yeah, right. Yeah, honey mustard. I just am kind of... I'm thinking if I go to Norm's, you know, I get the chicken. You know, I got the Chipotle. I got the honey mustard.
Honey mustard lacks versatility, but it's a strong flavor. I like it. It's definitely a 7-gamer, whatever happens here.
I'm going Chipotle. I like Chipotle doing it.
Okay.
I'm just picturing in my head, hey, I got a chicken strip. I'm dipping one in honey mustard. I'm eating it. Yeah, yeah. And then I'm dipping it in Chipotle. I'm like, ooh, okay, I like this little kick, but not much. Chipotle's not really that spicy. It's got a nice creaminess to it.
This is how we find out if Matt Lockwood listens. Because we should get an email.
So now what do we do here?
I'm fine with it going 4-3 Chipotle.
All right. Because we could postpone and have a tiebreaker.
Nah, this is first round. Like, tiebreakers come later.
All right.
When it matters.
All right, then let's advance Chipotle 4-3. I like what they're... I still like them a little bit.
Okay.
All right, great first round there of the sauces. Thank you, Adam. We appreciate that. Love to see all those sauces and some dressings in there. I've been really thinking about French dressing a lot. It's been on my mind.
Yeah.
I want to try it again.
After the pie draft, or the pie bracket, I was at the grocery store and I picked up a pre-made cherry pie.
Yeah.
At Ralph's. Triple cherry.
What? Triple?
I don't know what was triple about it. It's good. We didn't advance it beyond, I think, even the first round, but it's good.
Yeah.
I haven't had any desire to do it a la mode, though. I think that's still more of an apple thing.
I think cherry pie is more just whipped cream.
Yeah, probably.
I mean, triple cherry pie, it's like, okay, you don't need to say it like, okay, yeah, it's bursting with cherry flavor. The pie is already called cherry.
Yeah.
So we're ready for the flavor of cherry. You don't have to emphasize it.
Yeah.
Okay, we get it. We know that it's going to be cherry flavored. You don't have to go crazy with it.
Yeah.
All right, take it easy. Aaron, let's do some of our comments.
Okay.
And then I would like to do the next round of the potatoes consuming bracket.
Oh, yeah.
And then, of course, we have the cheese championship coming up right after that.
Okay. We've got Brandon Tyler doing his thing. Valuable work.
Thank you, Brandon.
SkyGod2000 says, in my defense of regarding Michael's email, we're still in this controversy.
Yeah.
He drives by a giant DQ sign every day for work, and the two single cheeseburgers for $6 and the two double cheeseburgers for $9 deal has been on the sign all summer. It's not my fault that he's freaking blind. We squashed, parentheses, and ate the beef at DQ last week. So they did share a burger.
Nice. Yeah, I mean, if it's on the sign, you know, he's got a point there.
Top Shot 8013 says, quote, calls potato salad a nuisance, unquote. That is an epic one-liner.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of people seem to agree. I stand by that statement.
Yeah. I agree, too. I don't think it's necessary, and it's the first. It's definitely the first one at a barbecue, outdoor barbecue, that goes bad.
Yeah.
You got to eat it or get it out of the fucking sun.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, when that gets hot, forget it.
Yeah. Eddie Castaneda, this is the last comment from last episode. Eddie Castaneda says, Aaron and Joe, I had the great pleasure of meeting your friend Brody when I was 14.
Wow.
In 2004, when I was in high school, my baseball team would go watch the best damn sports show, period. He was a freshman in high school, I would assume, at that age. Brody was the warm-up person. He kept the audience engaged and awake during the taping because John Kruk wasn't doing that. And Rob Dibble.
Yeah.
And let me tell you, he was a hoot. Funny and energetic. You were all lucky to know him personally.
Yeah.
Yes, we were.
Yeah, he was. Yeah, man. Yeah, it was great to get to know him when I started working at the Comedy Store. Yeah, it was. Yeah, it was a delight.
Yeah, getting a crowd going was Brody's thing, number one.
Yeah. That's it?
Yeah, that's it for comments.
All right. Oh, yeah, I got to do a Joe code here. Joe code for this week. Be polite to your Uber drivers or Lyft drivers. I had a great conversation with my driver here today, and I brought my, you know, I had my latte here that I brought, and I asked him, hey, can I use the cup holder, because it was in the middle console, and he's like, yes, you can. And you know what? I really appreciate you asking. He's like, thank you for asking. He's like, a lot of times people just eat in my car and do other things, and they don't even ask. He's like, that's really cool that you asked. You're a good guy. And we were also talking about how he's in IT, and he was telling me about the robots and how people are bad, like vandalizing the robots. It's like, come on, be polite, have manners, you know, leave the robots alone, be polite to Uber drivers, and don't eat in their cars, okay? I mean, would you even eat in your friend's car?
No, probably not.
I mean, you're going to sit in the back and eat a muffin and just make crumbs all over the place? You nitwit. Don't eat in their cars. Jeez. So, but actually the guy was telling me if people eat in the car and they mess it up, they get like for the cleaning or the inconvenience, they get $280 that goes straight to them.
Wow.
So he's like, if people want to eat, he's like, yeah, go ahead, eat. Because it's like, if they make the mess, jeez, then he gets the money, so.
That's crazy.
So he's encouraging the eating, but wow.
That's more than you'll pay in a cleaning fee at an Airbnb for a weekend.
Yeah.
So don't do it.
Completely nuts. Just a quick note of at work, and, you know, I just got to, you know, there's a thing at the Comedy Store where there's a back hallway where people, comedians especially, and like industry people and agents and stuff will want to hang out in the hallway of the Comedy Store. Now, the thing about this hallway is it's right outside two of the showrooms. So if you're in the hallway and you're being loud and trying to have a jolly good time, you're disrupting my shows. And I call them my shows because I work there and I take pride in the shows going well. I've been the hall monitor lately. I kick everybody out of the hallway.
Take it to the parking lot.
Yeah. Famous, non-famous. Take it outside. I'll name names if people want me to name names.
I'd be into that.
Take it outside, Whitney Cummings.
For sure. She's making a ruckus for two.
Take it outside, Bobby Lee.
Yep.
I mean, with his laugh in the hallway. But they know it, which is nice, too, because it's like you tell them and, you know, they're like, they apologize and they're like, yeah, we know, like, they get it. They're comics.
Yeah.
If they were on stage and people are laughing and disrupting, they wouldn't want that. And then people compliment me and they're like, yeah, we understand. Thanks. And so I'm great at my job. Just keep it down in my hallway. Hey, do you have a hall pass? No. Well, get out. I'm going to be like that guy in Saved by the Bell who's the hall monitor. Hey, detention for you. All right, let's do this. I want to do the next round of the forms of consuming potatoes bracket.
Okay.
We are in the semifinals. Aaron, do you remember the matchups?
I don't. Did the person update their...
No, but I'll do it because I know who won.
Okay.
So for the semifinals, first matchup we have from Riker. Thanks again, Riker, for doing this. We've got number one, French fries versus... Okay, yeah, the lowest seed. So number one, French fries versus number six... hash browns.
Oof.
You know, yeah, now these are going to be tough.
I mean, I think hash browns puts up a fight, but I don't think...
It's yeah, probably you don't 4-2. See the upset?
No, because you can have fries instead of hash browns and have a very good breakfast, but you can't have hash browns instead of fries... for dinner, like with a burger or whatever you would have fries with, a steak even.
Yeah, and then just thinking about the different different fries, you could have your so many different shapes. You can have your crinkle cut. You got shoestring steak fries.
Waffle curly.
Yeah, waffle. Oh, waffle fries are slept on. Curly fries. I've been opting for curly fries lately when I'm getting fries.
Yeah.
Man. And then, like, some, like, bars do those nice, like, thick. They're almost, like, crispy. Like, places that will do, like, fish and chips will have fantastic fries.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There's a lot of fries, as we've said before, with some of these teams, they've got... You know, they have just deep benches. They have too many weapons.
Yeah.
Hash browns is not ready.
They're great, but they're just not. They're great at one thing, one meal of the day.
I mean, but...
So, but fries could sneak in there and do their job.
Yeah. I mean, I like hash browns, though, putting up a, giving them a series.
Oh, yeah. I think
because I love what they do.
It's 4-2 at least.
Yeah. I'll say French fries wins 4-2.
Yeah.
To advance to the championship of the bracket.
Yeah.
All right, now here's another good matchup. French fries will face the winner of this team. Now we have number 2 mashed potatoes taking on number 4 potato chips.
I think this goes down the same way. I think it's 4-2, but I think mashed potatoes takes it.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't see that coming.
Yeah.
Whoa.
I mean, when you get a great mashed potato, there's chips will never feel like a great mashed potato.
I remember last time we were talking about the depth of mashed potatoes.
For sure there's depth.
Or, potato chips.
Yeah. They have depth, for sure. But the best potato chip you could ever have will never be as good as your best mashed potato experience. And there's depth of mashed potatoes, too. I mean, there's all sorts of cheese options. Chives.
I can't do it.
Wow.
Damn, we need a third for this.
Yeah.
All right. I'll get a guess next week. I don't know. Yeah, I think potato chips wins it 4-2.
Wow.
I like how what we talked about with them last week with the Lay's and the Ruffles and then places that make their own potato chips and just having potato chips as a snack. You know, you could bring them on the go.
Yeah.
They're delicious when I have them at work. I do love mashed potatoes as well. Yeah, I just don't see them.
There's nothing about mashed potatoes that couldn't be portable. It's just a matter of it's not done. But, you know, they're not a mess if you were to take them in a small container.
What would you think they win by?
I'd say 4-2.
I'd say 4-2 the other way.
All right, we need a tiebreaker. That's fine.
All right, yeah. You're not gonna cave this time?
No, I can't.
All right, fine. Good. That's fun. We'll put it on somebody else to take the heat. But yeah, I mean, that's bound to happen sometimes when it's only 2. All right, yeah. That'll be on hold.
Yeah, that's a deadlock right now.
Mashed potatoes. Potato chips going into overtime.
Yep.
I love it. Nice. All right, let me do a This Is Great, and then we'll do the cheese championship.
Okay.
All right. So, This Is Great is the cameo that I did for it was from Jeff and all his friends for their fantasy football draft. They had me pick all their names out of a hat and pick their draft order.
Oh, wow.
That was really cool. I've had a good amount of cameos before, but that was the most fun one that I've done. That was really cool.
That's a good use of it.
Yeah, great use of cameo. And so thank you guys. That was awesome to do. That was really cool. And I just hope you guys please honor the draft order that I picked. Okay. That's a good way to do it. I cut the squares evenly. I used my scissors, okay? They were 8. There was 8 of your guys' teams. I cut them in 8 equal sizes. I put them in my hat, mixed it around, picked the names. So honor what I did. And thank you guys for doing that. That was a lot of fun. Pleasure to do that. And then, yeah, just a reminder to everybody. Book me on Cameo. It's a fun time. Love to do those little videos for you guys. And then join the Patreon for $2 $2 a month at patreon.com, Joe Code Podcast, to support the pod. And then we're up near 1,200 YouTube subscribers. Subscribe to that YouTube channel, guys, if you haven't yet. So please do that. And all right, with that said, we've got a title match.
Oh boy.
To decide. We have, I mean, I forget the names of the, what do you call it, the conferences or whatever, but let me just...
was it Bobby Flay and...
No, it's just the conferences. Okay, so it's the Western Conference champion, number one, Cheddar Cheese, versus the Eastern Conference champion, number one, Mozzarella. Now, let's see if we could decide this in regulation time. Might go to overtime.
I don't think so.
Well, let's see what happens. I don't know what's in your head, Aaron. I'm not a freaking mind reader.
It comes down to this for me. Which of those two cheeses are you willing to eat in a huge quantity, like a pizza? And that's mozzarella. I wouldn't want 16 inches of cheddar.
That is a great point.
I mean, yeah, it's got burgers on its side, of course, you know, cheddar on a burger, way better than, you know, mozzarella doesn't even come in the equation.
Yeah.
But in terms of a large quantity of something, I'm going to want mozzarella all day.
I like that point. And the other thing I would say about mozzarella, which you don't really say about a cheese, I find mozzarella cheese refreshing.
Yep.
I used to...
I'll eat it out of the bag.
Yes, that's exactly what I was going to say. Back at home, when we would buy it, I would open the bag, the shredded mozzarella cheese, I would open the bag and just dump it in my mouth like that. And it was so good. And then there's fresh mozzarella.
Yep.
Oh my gosh. Don't even get me started with that.
I mean, if there was a brick of fresh mozzarella in front of me right now, I'd just take a bite out of it.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, cheddar's great. The thing is, I've even made nachos with mozzarella cheese.
Yeah.
And I know that's not you're supposed to use a Mexican cheese or even cheddar, which... But yeah, I mean... The thing is, you're not going to beat pizza. Yeah, I thought maybe you'd come in with some cheddar argument here, but...
No.
But yeah, no, cheddar does a lot of things right.
It absolutely does. That's why it's the number one.
They really do. It's great in a little cube. Great on sandwiches. Great on burgers. You know, you've got your Velveeta.
Oh yeah.
You know. But yeah, mozzarella with pizza and just as refreshing as it is, it's a special. It's really special.
Yeah.
Cheddar makes it kind of in. Yeah, I mean.
4-2?
4-2.
Sure.
I'd say it's like a Bulls Jazz in 98.
Yeah, it's not a 7-gamer, but there's a good fight. The four wins are still close.
Yeah, I mean mozzarella's—they're a powerhouse as well in their own right.
Yep.
But mozzarella does it.
Yeah.
All right, it's nice to crown a cheese champion here today. I like doing that.
Yeah.
And
I'd love to wear a crown of mozzarella cheese. Just saying.
So now we have, we've got the overtime of the potatoes bracket.
Yeah.
And then we'll continue with the sauce bracket. And I think that's all the brackets for now.
Yeah.
I don't think there's any other ones. I don't think I missed any. But yeah, we're going to be bringing... You better bet your ass there's going to be a guest next week to help us decide this potatoes thing.
Yeah.
That'll be good. All right, let me just do a rundown over the notes, which I'm glad I brought my freaking notebook this time.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a lot more helpful when... I mean, I've done enough of these to where it's like, okay, I'm composed enough to still do it, but I like to have this... you know, to fall back at. I'm freaking up here for over an hour talking. What am I just fucking going off memory like a dickhead? All right, yeah, that'll do it, guys. That's all of it. We nailed it. Lot of fun today. Puppies make me happy is what my shirt says. If you were watching this the whole time and being like, I can't read the bottom, what does it say? That's what it says.
Yeah.
Open your frickin' eyes. All right. Yeah, that'll do it. That's it. Joe Code episode 114. And thanks again, everybody. Love you guys out there. Appreciate all the emails and comments. Keep them coming. Love them. Love to read them. Love that you guys are a part of this podcast. So thank you guys. And we'll talk to you next time. This is Joe Code. I'm Joe Marrese.